Welcome back to the Sticky Art channel. If you're new here, my name is Justin, and in this video, I'm going to show how to draw on 3D objects and models using the app Procreate for the iPad. The Procreate 5.2 update just came out at the end of October, and drawing on 3D models is one of the biggest parts to the update. So to do any of the direct drawing on 3D objects or models, you're going to need to update Procreate. Just go over to the App Store, search Procreate, and there should be an option to update the app. Once you've downloaded and installed it, should go right to opening it. And on the top, you're gonna see what's new. And in here, you're going to see the different features. It'll run you over different things that are new. The big two things are gonna be the 3D models, and then the other is the new naming convention and the ability to name individual colors. Once you've downloaded the 3D model pack, you can click on any of the 3D models just like you would another canvas, click into it, and using one finger, you can move the object around. And then two fingers, you can slide it around on the screen as well as zoom in and zoom out using the zoom in and zoom out motion. And to draw on the object, all you'll need to do is tap on the object and then select a brush. And you can draw on the object just like you would a canvas. You can also move around the skateboard or the object and then draw on it in different angles. And I found that drawing on flat objects is pretty simple, but then when it comes to drawing on more 3D things, it can provide kind of a challenge. But as for all the normal functions of Procreate, you can hold the pen down and get smoothed out lines. You can do everything that you can in Procreate, but on the 3D object. So it's a really nice kind of feature to be able to do that directly on the object and be able to size and move things around sometimes that you would not be able to see on a flat object. And there is a way to actually just import a image. You can do that and then put it directly on a 3D object as well, just by importing an image like you would normally into Procreate. But I went ahead and just decided I would draw directly on the skateboard just to try it out. And overall, it was a lot of fun. I found it was like customizing something, but super easy. And the ability to just change everything and do everything I can in Procreate on the object is a very cool idea. The new update should allow you to import pretty much any object file or OBJ file, which I'm super excited about, importing some of my sculptures from some other programs and drawing directly on them. And when I do this, I will definitely make a video on it and post it in the near future. So if you are interested in that, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications for when I post. And you are able to go into the options and actually look at the 2D texture map. This is a flat version of a 3D object kind of blown out. You can also draw directly on the 2D texture map if you want to. However, if you're not familiar with 3D modeling and how that kind of explodes out, it might be a little confusing, but it's definitely something that is good to know, especially if you're planning on doing more 3D modeling type projects. One place that this can be really helpful is on 3D objects that are round, or you'd have to keep turning the object around like the wheels to get all the sides. So instead of doing that, I turned on the 2D texture and I colored in the wheels that way to make sure I didn't miss any spots. Once I got the wheels and the bearings all colored in, I came back in and colored up the trucks. And one thing that I found interesting is that these had kind of a texture map applied to them. And when I painted over them, all the texture mapping went away, which kind of makes sense. But at the same time, I would have thought that maybe it would have shown through still, or there would be a way to keep the texture mapping or properties at the same time as coloring it in. So if you had, like, say, a metallic texture or something like that, it would still have that. But from what I can tell in here, there's not really a way to do that. So when you do color over things, you are going to get a flat color of what it is. And same thing on the little screws. You can see that these were just a texture. Once I colored over them, there was no little screw, little markings or anything like that anymore. It just was kind of a flat object. So something to keep in mind. Once I was happy with it, I wanted to check it out in virtual reality or augmented reality. And you can go to the settings and then select view in AR. And here you don't have as many options to rotate it around. You can only move the object around in the actual environment. And then using two fingers can rotate it on one axis. I wasn't able to figure out how to rotate it in any other axis than that. It just was in that upright position, but still pretty cool. and it gives you a good idea of what the final product would look like. Say if you were making a skateboard design or something and you wanted to see it in real life before maybe printing it. At the time of making this, there isn't any actual interactivity with 3D objects. However, I think it'd be a really cool idea in the future that maybe that there could be that capability where you could pick up and test it out just like a little finger skateboard. And other than that, I'm really impressed with how great the quality is. You can scale the objects up rather large. So you can look at them in the actual environment, but in a large form. So this would be like a real skateboard. And I think that it is really cool that you can actually do that. And one last feature of the update that you're able to adjust is going to be the lighting and environment. So on these glasses, you can see the lenses are reflective. You can actually see the reflection of the environment in there. And if you come into the environment setting, you can change it from studio and scroll all the way through these. There's some city, there's as well as mountains, outdoors, indoors, different settings that you can place your objects in. And this could be really handy if you're trying to show off an object or trying to figure out what an object would look like in more of a native setting. And not only can you do that, you can go into the lighting settings. You can add a light, change where the source of the light sits. And all this is really cool that it's all built in. So I'm gonna go ahead and customize these sunglasses for Sticky the Frog. Just do a quick customization. And this is something where you could spend a lot of time coming in here and zooming in and try and get all the details. If you do go through quickly and just do this haphazardly, there's a lot of times where the actual colors kind of spill over from one side to the other. And you can also do things like drop color in just like you would on a normal canvas. But on these, you can see where the pixels kind of spill over. So I don't really have a way of fixing that other than going back over and coloring everything. But I added in some little sticky logos. One thing I've been working on for a little while too with the channel is some merchandise. Let me know in the comments below what kind of merchandise you might want to see from the channel. Maybe little figurines or a coloring book or anything that you have in mind. I have a few ideas in my mind, but I want to see what everybody wants. And especially with the holidays coming up, I'm also going to be working on some digital brushes as well as a store for everything sticky. And I'm super excited to announce that I will be launching Patreon later this month. So stay tuned for all the updates. And thanks so much for checking out this video. I hope it was helpful. If you did enjoy it, make sure to give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe and turn on post notifications for when I post my newest videos. And until next time, peace.